as of this morning, summer officially over. It's time for autumn football, and we're underway on EA Sports. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. They go play action with Hurts. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll be out right at the 35. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. They will run for the first time with Miles Sanders. And that is not going to get it done either. Once again, he's stopped behind the line by this Bengals D. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be third down. Open man, it's Rager. He's got it. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A first down and then some. Give him 29 yards.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
A 7-yard pickup.
Here's Hurts to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the former first rounder, Trey Waynes. 30, 10,
in your face.
And he will bring it back. It's a pick six for a Bengals TD.
Well, it certainly looked to me like he tapped into the quarterback's thought process there. And what I'm hearing more and more when I go around the league, defenders sitting in on quarterback meetings trying to learn more about how they think so they can be in the right position to be in the right spot, as he was there to pick that one off and take it all the way back for a touchdown.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Taken about 7 yards deep. Starting a hole as he's brought down at the 11.
But conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion. Second down. Here's Jalen Hurts. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Man, and he hits him in stride. It across the 25 before being tackled. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15.
First and 10 at the 26-yard line.
Play action. Here's Hurts. Flushed out right. And that's off the mark, incomplete. So he's 3 for 7 throwing the football right now. Not an awful start, but also not the sharpest of starts.
No, I would agree with that. But if you're a confident quarterback and to play that position you have to be, you just act like there's something wrong with the wind currents or something wrong with the ball. It is not you. Keep throwing. That timing usually develops.
And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
The Browns got a good team, bro.
From the gun, it's Hurts. And his throw here is incomplete. He was looking for Miles Sanders out of the backfield. That'll bring up second down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about 5. Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Now he steps away, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. And a play like that, with how far he had to go to make that sack, shows how athletic defensive ends have become in the NFL.
And not just athletic, this is coached in a big way. Run to the football at all times. How about him never giving up on it and pursuing all the way across the field?
He'll fire it deep for Rager, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off around the 27, and he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well, and they took the shot downfield. They were more than prepared for that one.
And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. And credit the tackle to Derek Barnett. On second down, here's Mixon.
It's time, baby.
And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Joe Mixon, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals strike quickly here for 6 points.
So there, Charles, I mean, a situation where it didn't matter how far he had to run, he was not going to be denied, and he winds up taking this all the way to the end zone.
I think defensively, when you look at a play like that, that's when everyone looks at their teammates and starts shaking their heads a little bit, because now you're wondering, what are we in for? Worked all week to try and limit the big play ability that he possesses, and he winds up taking one to the house in the very first quarter. That was a tremendous run.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Eagles take over 1st and 10 at their own 25.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. I'll try and get things settled down a little bit.
Well, CD, I mean, there are touchdown runs, and then there are touchdown runs, and that one certainly fell into the latter category, and that deserves a couple exclamation points.
And what I really enjoyed about that run and what made it so impressive to me was how he improvised along the way. Sometimes on a big play, you just get the football and you take off in a straight line and go. But this time, how about the artistry of that play?
Yeah, he covered a lot of ground on that one, as evidenced by the final total there on Next Gen Stats.
3 weeks, 3 touchdowns. It's obvious they've worked his way early and often in the red zone this year. That's usually a pretty good place to find a tight end in the NFL.
Elliott good on the extra point, and that'll make our score 14-7.
This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
2 yards. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology.
Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be 3rd and 3 now.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on 3rd down.
Oh,
From the shotgun, it's Burrow. Going to throw right side here, complete. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score.
First quarter, Bengals score, Bengals 14, Eagles 7.
They will throw on first down with Burrow. Airing one out for Boyd. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Tyler Boyd, the former Pitt Panther, was the target. But it'll be second down. Here's Burrow. He'll air this one out for Boyd. This is caught inside the 15. But he is taken down deep in Philadelphia territory.
If there was one knock on Joe Burrow coming out of LSU, it was arm strength, but kind of put those doubts to rest right there.
To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
On third down, Mixon. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6.
That call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, and they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes.
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders, his second touchdown on the season. And the Eagles are able to strike quickly for 6. So that run there, yeah, I don't know if it's overstating things to call it a thing of beauty, but in terms of football plays, that's as good as you're going
to
see.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Now this will make it into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10 at their own 16. They'll hand it off here. This is Mixon. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
On second down now, Mixon. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. A yard in the wrong direction. Makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense. A little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them. But they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
On third down, Burrow. Intercepted. Picked off at the 35. And they will finally put it into the return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line. Suddenly it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Throwing is Hurts. Rolling to his right. to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Rookie Jalen Reagor, the intended target that time.
But it'll be second and goal.
Partner, this is almost an unwinnable spot for a defense. They have to come right out for a first and goal trying to stop them. But let me hold on a second. Let me take that back real quick. They can win here if they force a field goal try. Still a long ways away from that happening, but that has to be what they're thinking right now.
And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Jalen Hurts for his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Eagles have taken the lead.
That was not a designed run. It was supposed to be a pass, but it turned into an exceptional run. What a scramble for a touchdown.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and that gives him a 3-point lead.
And this carries into the end zone.
Well, conventional football 101 tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
No gain on the play there. Second down. On second down, Nixon. And some room to maneuver. Cincinnati score. Joe Mixon with his second touchdown of the game, 4th of the year. And the Bengals are going to jump back in front. They erased that deficit pretty quickly, did they not? A 2-play drive.
What do we call that? Short-lived?
Very.
Very short-lived. 2 plays later, they're in the end zone and back out in front. We always talk about drives, don't we? Does 2 plays count as a drive?
Not really, but that second play was so good. I don't care what we call it. It was enjoyable to watch.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Eagles take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. The play fake. Here's Hurts. Left side here to Sanders. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a 1st down. Hurts. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders.
No.
Calling a gain of 5, and it's a 2nd down.
All defense is worried that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Once you hit stick on, bro.
A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
He's going to sling this deep downfield. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. A big play there. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Eagles have retaken the lead. And it's up and good.
Makes the score. Eagles 27. Eagles 23.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This taken in about 4 yards deep.
But conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
He's brought down at the 15-yard line.
Now it's Burrow, able to find Higgins. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 14-yard line. Now they're staring at a third and eight. That last play, backwards a yard. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Rodney McLeod. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the side.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Trey Hendrickson picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
At the 27.
Second down. Here's Hurts. And he finds his tight end. It's Hurts. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Going up top. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Early on, the running game's been working well, and the offensive line has been pleased by that. The thought process there, catch those safeties creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They tried to hit them over the top, unsuccessfully.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. Yards that time on the punt, and the Bengals will take over here first and 10. The Bengals drive about to get going, and with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Flush to his right. And now ball going to be intercepted yet again. Picked off by Anthony Harris. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Hurts sets up to throw it. And this is caught at the end. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Zach Ertz. In the final seconds of the first half, and the Eagles had 6-0 lead.
And that's a lead that excites a team as they head into the half. Good way to finish things off.
Yeah, able to extend that lead, and you always say it, it can totally change the complexion of half number two.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook. But even before that, let's see if they decide to kind of squib kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff, because you don't want to give up a big play right before the half ends.
Good point.
Darius Phillips on the return. The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
Meanwhile, their run on first down really backfires as he's going to be brought down well behind the line of scrimmage. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando. That's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports halftime report. Coach, the Bucs set to get the football first, and they trail here as we get started in the second half. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. Mixon will get it to start the second half. And he'll take this one up to about the 23. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
They'll stay on the ground. Mixon again. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
And a good pickup there by Mixon, and that shows the talent that he has. Back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons, fourth in the NFL 2018, ninth last year. But I look for those numbers to jump back up again with the introduction of new talent in Cincinnati. Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. And when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Eluding the pressure right. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick, and it's third down. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Love the idea, love the concept. But you got to leave a little room on the sideline so he can fade into it when he makes the catch. That was thrown too close to it for the receiver to make a play.
They'll go for it. Burrow. Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. Throwing left side, it's complete. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. A big play there for the Bengals. 43 yards, and he is in. Touchdown, Bengals. Taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Bengals have got it back to a one-score game.
All the normal traits.
He's got the hat trick, 3 touchdowns now.
Did you throw yours? Did you throw yours?
I didn't have mine. You've got yours. You've got one of those Abe Lincoln hats.
Yeah, and that stovepipe is going right out there for a nose for the end zone. Third time today. I think he deserves a tip of the cap.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. His throw is going to be incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
That's one thing about Bengals. Bengals got a fast ass.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And some space here. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
And some room to work. The 20. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Joe Mixon, 47 yards. And thanks to the interception, the Bengals offense cashes in with six. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it. But he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They had that lead that is now gone. It is completely gone. Yeah, how does that affect the psyche? Am I reading into that too much? They should be okay still. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
One thing that I liked about this guy during the draft process was his motor. Of course, I loved his skills, but he plays hard on every down.
And that motor on full display there as he gets his first NFL sack. Complete.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
This long complete to Rager. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. They'll try and throw for it here. And this is incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Bengals are going to get it back in terrific field position. First down. Here's Burrow. Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzama. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 13, and the Bengals have a first down. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. A gain of 6 there on first.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast. Of course, you've got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness is a premium for all of that now.
On second down, Burrow. His pass caught at the 4. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. An 11-yard touchdown. And the Bengals, they widen their lead. And his kick is good.
Makes the score Bengals 45, Eagles 30.
Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we seen?
And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure. Trey Hendrickson getting him once again his third sack of the afternoon. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big...
And he's going to be taken down. Sacked back at the 2.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches. When they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Back to throw now in his own end zone. And he took the contact as he was throwing it. And the ball drops incomplete.
Incomplete. It's now fourth down.
The Eagles send out their punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he'll just punch it out of there, and it's not a great kick.
the end of the third quarter with the score Bengals 45, Eagles 34.
On first and 10, Joe Burrow escaping the pressure right. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Throwing now, Burrow on first down. He gets this in the hands of Mixon, and they'll get this down to the 10. Mark that as a gain of 16 to set him up first and goal.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Now Burrow on first down. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. T. Higgins was the intended target, but it'll be second and goal.
Brings up second and goal.
And Burrow going to throw again. Flushed out right. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the one. The improv act there, good for 9. And now they'll be looking at a third and short, third and one. A lot of tired bodies on that field. But this is a big play, third and goal. Burrow looking to pass. And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. C.J. Uzama, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Bengals add on to their lead. And they're able to up the lead by one more.
Makes the score Bengals 52, Eagles 30.
Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25.
First and 10 at the 50-yard line.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Going deep here for... This is caught inside the 15. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Quez Watkins, 50 yards. And the Eagles get a score closer.
You got to understand situational football because they're playing with the lead here late in the ball game. So the back defender has got to be as deep as the deepest receiver. Keep everything in front of you, rally up and make the play.
Yeah, you would think they had the 3-score lead. Now it's down to 2, but 3-score lead here late that they wouldn't give up a big pass play like that, but they did.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. Well, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs to keep up with your theme there, playing keep away. First downs, they can't touch the ball.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Nigel Bradham brings them down.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the 4 fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the 4 fingers for 4-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it, and let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. They will throw on first down with Burrow. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. A wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
Second and 10 now, Burrow. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Brandon Graham applying the heat off the edge. Chalk that up as their first sack in this game, and they tallied four a week ago.
And probably not as much exultation in that sack as what took us so long. Because when you get four the previous week, you're counting on continuing that momentum. They didn't get that done in the first half of the game. Let's see now if they start to bring even more exotic pressure towards the quarterback.
Now Joe Burrow on third and long. Going right side here, and that's complete. They get 13, but it's not nearly enough. And it'll be fourth down. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They'll try and throw forward with Burrow. Flush to his right. And that was incomplete. Nigel Bradham, the linebacker, right there on the coverage. And I am not sure, partner, there what the mindset was to go for it. I don't know.
And some teams just feel that possession is the key to everything. They just want to have the football in their hands. No matter how it goes to the other team, they just don't trust doing that. So they say, listen, go for it and try and finish it ourselves.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. They go play action with Hurts. Oh, and Hurts is going to be hit and taken down to the ground. The Eagles on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This will be a tough third and 18. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Bengals will get the football back. Trying to eat some clock with Mixon. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and 7. Once again, they run with Mixon. Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. A 1-yard gain there following the 3-yard pickup on first down. On third down, Mixon. 4 yards on the pickup there, but it's going to take him to fourth down. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. The offense going to stay out there. They've converted once, failed once. What can they do here on fourth down? From the shotgun, it's Burrow. Eluding the pressure right. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. That one a backbreaker as they wind up converting there on fourth. From midfield now, Burrow. And And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. They go play action with Burrow. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Yeah, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. On third down, Burrow. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down. Burrow going for it on fourth. He's going to go up top again. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. The Bengals try it, but it doesn't work out. And this defense will take over right at midfield. The Eagles in good position to start out as they come up first and 10, right at the 50-yard line. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off at the 38.
Well,
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Bengals, they're into the win column now as they move to 1-2 on the young season. And they'll return home next week to take on the Jacksonville Jaguars. Meanwhile, for Philadelphia, they suffer defeat for the first time as they drop to 2-1. And they'll try to get back to their winning ways next week as they head to Santa Clara to take on the 49ers. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Bro.
They did not want me to go places. Yeah. Spoiled plans like the gold place. And if we're pulling up with the whole squad, are you ready? Then told y'all that you better be running. I'm in my go yard when I walk in, I know y'all telling me nothing.
Yeah.
I'm
a man. My mind,
so I gave y'all a denial. I get the chip on them and I bust out the south side. Is that big of the guy?
Boy, you stop it quiet. If it's new, I done got it. See my jewels shining, shining. White diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot. Look at me. Stylish, stylish. Masterpiece. Body, body. Hey,
I don't know no.
I don't let bygones be bygones. It's, that's when I'm honest. Penthouse building, reach heaven's heights. Now that's what you call
nobody.
Remember the days I was down low when it was out cold, but I went out and got it. Look at my milestones, man. It feel like the Dow Jones when you look at my pocket. Look at
bro,
the flex.
Down, bro.